A multi-cylinder engine is to run at a speed of 600 rpm. On drawing the turning moment diagram of the scale of 1 mm equal to 250 Newton meter and 1 mm equal to 3 degree. The area above, below and mean torque lines are in mm squared are 150, 72, 168, 191, 197, 162. So this value clearly shows that this is the turning moment diagram of steam engine. The speed is to be varied within plus or minus 1% of mean speed. The fluctuations of speeds are plus or minus 1% of mean speed of the engine. From that, we can calculate the CS value. The fluctuations of speed omega 1 minus omega 2 equal to plus or minus 1%. So 1% means 0.01, plus or minus 1 means plus 1 minus 1, I can take it as 0.02. So 0.02 is the value of CS, and here the omega represent mean speed, so it will come like this: omega 1 minus omega 2 equal to 0.02% of omega, fluctuations of speed equal to 1% of plus or minus 1 means 0.02% of omega. That is the meaning of that term. Calculate the necessary moment of inertia. We need to find the value of I. Then determine the suitable dimension of the rectangular flywheel. So we have to calculate the breadth and thickness of the flywheel rim. Again, breadth is twice the value of thickness. So B equal to 2T. That is also given. Then the density of cast iron is 7250 kg meter cube, and the shear stress value equal to 6 megapascal, 6 into 10 power 6 newton per meter square. The rim contributes 92% of the flywheel effect. Again, del E of rim equal to 92% of del E of actual del E value. So with this detail, now we are directly moving to turning moment diagram. And before that, we will find the scale factor. One side we have 1 mm into another 1 mm, 1 mm squared. We can take it as 1 mm squared. Whereas another side I have 250 into 3 degree. So I can take 3 degree as pi by 60. Then 250 into pi by 60, 13.1 Newton meter. So this is the scale factor for 1 mm square. And this is the turning moment diagram. 160 plus, 172 minus, 168 plus, like that it will go on. X-axis represent crank angle, y-axis represent turning moment. Let's find energy at different point. Energy at point A, I can take it as E, capital E value. Energy at B, capital E plus 160. Energy at C, energy at B minus 172. What is the value of energy at B? E plus 160 minus of 172. So you will get this value. Then energy at point D, energy at point C plus 168. Energy at point C, this is the value, energy at point C plus 168. So you will get this value. Like that you can find energy at point E, F and G. If you see the first and last value, you will get E. So it clearly says that you performed all the calculation properly. Now we can find del E. So what is del E? Maximum energy minus minimum energy. Here the maximum value, see there are a lot of values here, and here the maximum value is E plus 162, minimum value E minus 35. Then subtract both these value, you can cancel this term, you will get 197 meter square. We know that 1 meter square equal to 13.1 Newton meter. Then multiply 197 with 13.1, you will get 2581 Newton meter. That is the change in or fluctuation of energy for this given flywheel. Now del E equal to I omega squared CS. Del E value 2581, I value, I need to find out omega given 62.84 power 2, then CS value 0.02, so you will get 79 I, from that I equal to 32.7 kg meter square. So this is the answer for subdivision 1, moment of inertia of given configuration of flywheel. Next, we need to find the dimension of the flywheel. Tau is equal to rho v squared. So this is the value of tau which is given, then rho into v squared, density 7250 which is given data, then velocity we need v squared. So from that v squared equal to 827.6, again v equal to 28.8 meter per second. We know that velocity equal to pi d n by 60. Actually we need a dimension. Dimension means diameter. So diameter equal to, rearrange all the term, again n value known, v value also known, substitute all the parameters, known values, you will get a diameter of 0.92 meter. This is the value of diameter. Next, I need to find the dimensions, breadth and width. For that formula, mass equal to rho v, volume density into volume, rho v. Again, to find T and D, I need mass. So to calculate mass, I need to substitute in this formula, del E is equal to I omega squared c. But there is one given term in the problem, del E rim equal to 92% of del E. So already we know that del E value, then 0.92 times of that value equal to 2375 newton meter, that is del E rim. Let's take the del E rim, where del E rim equal to mv squared cs. Mass I need to find out, v velocity already known, then cs value also known. Now rearrange the term, you will get mass equal to 143 kg. Now substitute mass in this formula, mass equal to 143, then volume as I said in the previous video, this is flywheel, this is the shape of flywheel. When you cut the flywheel at this point, the cross section look like a rectangle. Then thickness, breadth, so breadth into thickness times of circumference equal to volume, circumference pi d. That's why I have used this formula, breadth into thickness area pi d a. So pi d a represent volume into density. So 143 equal to pi into d value 0.92, where is d, here we have d 0.92, then breadth equal to 2 times of thickness, then thickness equal to t, density value already known. So when you substitute all these parameters, you will get 41,914 t squared equal to 143. From that I can find t value. So t equal to 58.4 mm. Then what is breadth? Breadth is equal to 2 times of thickness. So you will get 116.8. Normally we can take this as a thickness and this is a breadth. So breadth equal to 2 times of thickness. Okay, so this is the final value of thickness of flywheel, breadth of the flywheel, then mass of the flywheel. So these are the dimension of given flywheel. So this is how you can use turning moment diagram and all the parameters to find the various dimension of flywheel. Don't forget to post your questions in the comment box. You can also mention the topics which you expect from my channel. Subscribe my channel and like my video to support my video lecture.